I think about me now and who I could have been. And then I picture all the perfect that we lived. Till I cut the strings on your tiny violin. Hello dear students, I hope you are doing well. In this video I just wanted to show off my BMW 5 Series E60, and you know, I just created a subdivision model based on the reference. The reference is actually a mesh, so let me just copy that and paste that into the new layer right here. Okay, so here's the reference. You know, I just used the reference to create this subdivision mold. You can use a tool called retopology in subdivision in order to create a mold based on a mesh. And you know, the quality of this mold is good enough, but the quality of my mold should be improved. That's because I just work on this in a few hours. So this is the result of a few hours of alias modeling, and you know, some reflections and some parts needs to be get revised. Okay, so let me just turn on the subdivision points, and as you see here, the mold includes a few subdivision faces and points. You know, the points are not too much, and also the faces, and that's why the model is actually clean right now. But you know, in some areas you have to, for example, on the back bumper and here over here, you need to have so many points of subdivision vertices. That's because you have to change the crown sometimes and have a special complex shape, and in order to do that you have to increase the number of vertices. Okay, I will complete this and share another video with you guys to see what's the final result and how many hours did it take to create this BMW 5 Series. You know, all the details are also in SubD. As you can see here, it just created with SubD, and you know, I didn't use the topology tool for all of the car surfaces, but I just used that in order to match some points or edges into the reference. And you know, you have to take care about the reflections and crowns and surface flaws, because it's very important. You know, for example, here I have a very beautiful side and very clean side. And why this happened? Because I just used a line to curve tool. It means I just aligned each row of this subdivision vertices into a curve, and then edited the curve, so the final result will have much better quality. Okay, I'll share another video soon, and will show you the details that you can create with subdivision mode. Thank you so much and have a nice day. And just wait a minute, I just forgot to tell you about our website and learning platform called learn.ms3d.net. If you check out this amazing website, you can watch out some courses for subdivision modeling and also nerve modeling. You know, our subdivision modeling is actually our most trending course, and there are many, many people who joined this course and enjoyed it a lot. And it's actually 100% satisfiable course. And you know, we have also other courses like bundles that you can purchase for a package of all courses or bundles. And here we have just added a few details about each course, a little bit information about what you're gonna learn during this course, some testimonials and FAQs. So so you can find your frequently asked questions here. Okay, you can also at the end of the this page check out our students' work, and if you click on it, you will go to the MS3D.net website. Our students' work are here, and you can just scroll down and watch out our students' work for subdivision molding courses and also nerve molding courses. Thank you so much, and have a nice day. And the tasty, and people say